如果我能用一个词汇来形容我妈妈，我会说是耐心。
The one word that I can describe about my mom is that she is loving.
I'm not sure whether this is the right word to use, but she's quite a magnanimous person.
生命当中不可或缺的。
So one of the things she always tell me, at least, is she said, because I was the eldest, so she asked me to do house chores. And she always say this line, I want you to learn and I want you to do this because I do not want you to burden your wife in future. But fast forward, now I'm married with two kids. I think I was trained quite well from my mom. Trained so well that I think when it comes to house chores, I'm a little bit more particular. So that was something my mom did which I kind of appreciated now, which then I didn't appreciate.
小时候我的家人一直以来是没有那种庆祝生日的习惯，但是他每一年他都会记得煮面线，还有煮水煮蛋，然后生日的人可以吃两颗。就算不是很大的一种庆祝方式，不需要很多人或者是很热闹，但是他是会在很小的事情上告诉你他记得今天是你的生日，他用他的行动来告诉你我记得你。
One memory that comes to mind is I think growing up is that she was constantly trying to be present, I think for everything that required a parent, whether it was like a concert at school or whether it was prefects installation service, she would try to make it. Now as a parent, I realized that, she wanted to be there because she realized her presence was important.
我以前就奇怪为什么妈妈这么喜欢吃面包，在吃早餐或者午餐呢，妈妈都会打包东西给我吃，打包面啊，打包饭啊。可是她有时候就是，虽然打包给我面或饭，她自己反而是擦面包，然后每次我问他，妈咪，这么你不吃面不吃饭只吃面包，他就讲，哎，我喜欢吃面包啊，就很喜欢吃啊。我长大了过后来到吉隆坡读书做工，然后有些时候经济比较紧的时候，我也同样的会买面包当饭吃，过后才发觉原来不是因为妈妈喜欢吃面包，是因为她要把最好的给我们，她愿意自己牺牲。
If my mom was here today, I guess I would say thank you so much, mom, for teaching my brothers about life. Thank you so much for all your sacrifice. We're all doing okay. Your grandkids are doing okay. And don't worry about us. One day we'll meet again. I'm really thankful that you know Jesus. Although it's a temporary separation, but I'm glad that one day we'll meet again. Yeah.
Mommy, 我知道我从小到大是蛮叛逆的，也破碎了你的心好几次，可是你对我的爱永远都没有变过。我很感恩的就是上帝让我们在这几年里面，我们这一家无论经历了什么风暴，过去五年我们家里真的是经历了好多东西，可是我也知道妈咪对你来说你也是很辛苦，经历了很多事情，可是我很感恩的，因为有主的恩典，我们的这一家人反而对彼此的爱是 变得更加的深，对彼此的看顾也增加了不少。每一次有什么东西发生，你都会叫我不要担心，事情发生在你身上，你都会说不要担心。你就是以一个母亲的心，你的就这样的爱着我。无论虽然我现在长大了一些，可是你对我的爱都完全没有变过。所以妈咪，我只想跟你说我爱你，然后希望呢我们接下来会有更多更多美好的回忆。
I think she was right in front. I would say thank you for everything. I think it's never easy being a mom. And I recognize that, you know, she's given so much, the sacrifice as a parent all these years. And sometimes, you know, when we are adults, we forget all the things that have, you know, that has been done to help us be where we are today. And I just want to say thank you. You know, for the many, many things, you know, whether it's been said or unsaid, but, you know, things that we really appreciate that you've done for me and the family. And so I think, I think the tears itself is already loads of words in many ways, yeah. But I really want to say thank you because in the way that she has loved us, you know, it has given me a glimpse of God's love in so many ways. So that spoke to my heart.
I know. 我们可能很少把谢谢、我爱你，还有对不起挂在嘴边，而且我们也有吵架的时候，也有说话伤害对方的时候，然后就面对面道歉和拥抱说我爱你这种，对我们来讲是一个很奇怪或者很尴尬的事情。可是其实在每一天的生活当中，你为我们所做的事，我是能够知道你是爱我们的。然后其实我也在用我的方式来告诉你，我并没有一直在生你的气，而且我其实是很感恩也很感激你为我们做的事。虽然母亲节我们也不习惯去庆祝，可是是想告诉你，真的很谢谢你为我们的家所做的一切。
我不是一个完美的人，我们总对爱的人最残忍。看着你受伤的眼神，你怎么还能爱着我这样的人？我知道你对我的爱像一座山，觉得，我觉得这是理所当然。我超想，我的缺点你怎么都能接纳，因为我更好的人守护在你身旁。我不是一个完美的人，当我想和你过完这一生。